AKISAN, U.S. Incorporated, is an acronym for Akwaibom State Association of Nigeria, U.S. Incorporated. It is a group of Akwaibom State indigents based in the United States of America. Every year, this diaspora group visits home to contribute their bit to fatherland. 2019 was no exception, as the group visited home to give back to the society. Led by its president, Lady Margaret Itauma, 40 medical volunteers visited home under the auspices of AKISAN to organize a free medical and surgical outreach in the three senatorial districts of the state. And this was in partnership with FERES, the pet project of the state's first lady, Her Excellency Mrs. Martha Udumimano. Simultaneously for 5 straight days, the over 40 foreign medical volunteers and about 120 home-based medical experts stormed General Hospital in Etina and Ibiakun Tubopo, Ikono local government area, and Cottage Hospital in Benogu, Esereke local government area, to tend to the needs of the natives in the areas. Major and minor surgical operations, free eyeglasses, as well as routine and prescription drugs were administered freely to the people in the three locations. In General Hospital, Ibiakun Tubopo, Ikono local government area, for instance, the hospital's operating theater was a behave of activity, with the medical experts cutting open the natives in over 61 major and minor surgical operations. Isaiah Akban, the medical personnel in charge of the operating theater, gives more insight into the surgical process.
Akwaibom State Indigenous resident at the United States of America have organized a free medical treatment for indigents of Ikono and beyond. So they have been here since Monday this week. They have done various operations, neuropathies, myomectomies, thyroidectomies, and all those cases. Well, we should be thankful to them, because it is not easy to do something good for another person. So we should thank them and pray for them that God should continue to bless them.
To complement the effort of the AKISAN, USA Incorporated, the local government chairman, Mr. Ituro Colomba, bought and donated over 500 pieces of eyeglasses to his kid and kin. The free eyeglasses were therein distributed to the natives' helmet after proper medical examination and eye checkup by the experts. The lead medical personnel from the United States in Ikono General Hospital, Bishop Dr. Samuel Atong, and other foreign medical experts, took time off the busy schedules to give an oversight into the medical outreach.
If you can see here, there's a group in the U.S. called Applied Group Status. They got together and started to give things back to the communities where we come from. And Ikono happens to be one of them. So we volunteer to come in here and learn that medical services. As you can see, that we've done in 5 days. So it's been a wonderful event. I hope we've touched the lives of many people as possible. Before I can begin to give credit, I'd like to give credit to your chairman, Mr. Ikono Kolomba. He's been wonderful. You know, I can't begin to express my appreciation. He's been here, making life comfortable for us, as well as his subjects. So I want to say thank you to him, as well as other officers in Ikono. They have done well. I can also add that the administration of this hospital has been fantastic. They've come to our aid in everything we have. So once again, I'm thankful to Dr. Otu and the rest of the year. First of all, this is his state, and I'm honored and thankful to be one of his subjects from work. So I will say to him, thank you for creating an environment where people like me and the rest of my colleagues can come in peace, but come in and give back to our states. I think a governor has to create that environment, and it's done well. And also to the wife, if you look at the poster here, she's one of the partners. So I'm very thankful to her and everybody else.
We are here on behalf of our Ikono State Association of Nigeria, USA, to do a medical mission here at Ikono. I've been in many other outreach that we've done in a different organization. This one is outstanding. Outstanding in the fact that right from the chairman of this local government, Ikono, is an outstanding person that I've been able to meet personally. And I've told him in person that you are an outstanding young man, because from day one we had a planning meeting to this day, he has given us 200% support in this mission. Number two, the people that came out here have really shown us that there are greater needs for us to come back. So this outreach is successful, and it's very, very exciting for us to be a part of it. And a mission that is successful.
At some point, the effervescent chairman atop the local council, Ms. Ikono Kolomba, arrived at General Hospital to ascertain the extent of the outreach. He was accompanied by AKISAN's president, Lady Margaret Itaoma. Together, he entered the theater to relate with the patients, as well as admire the AKISAN baby and the newborn delivered during the outreach via cesarean section.
So this is our fifth AKISAN baby. We have 5 in Eket and we have 1 in Ikono. Baby, welcome to the world. He is cute. God bless you. Baby, welcome to the world.
Outside the operating theater, the AKISAN president, assisted by the AKISAN chapter chairman of Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. UM George extolled the virtues of both the foreign and home-based medical teams.
I'm only the chapter president in Atlanta. Overall president in the U.S. is Ms. Margaret Itauma. Madam President, please come to be recognized. That's Ms. Margaret Itauma. We have over 1,500 cases with 61 surgeries, including AKISAN baby. Yes. Baby boy. Okay. And then we've had tremendous support from the chairman of Ikono Local Government Council, Honorable Ikono Colombo. This is the chairman of the local council. He's been of tremendous support for this trip. And Dr. Samuel Otong leads our team. He's a medical doctor from New York. He leads our team here. And the team lead for surgery. There is Dr. Otto Asukwa. Thank you so much. Welcome to it. So I'll allow my president. This donation comes from AKISAN. This is one of the surgeons in the team. Dr. Obum. So this team is one of us. This is a health educator from New York.
I am excited to be in Akwa Ibom to give back to my community. I want to thank God Almighty for giving us this vision to come back and serve our community. We appreciate the First Lady, Mrs. Martha Odom Emmanuel. What we are doing is in line with her federal project, and also this complements the governor's vision to give good health to our tribal citizens. We want to thank the medical superintendent of this facility, Dr. Ekuto, for giving us the opportunity to come here and serve. The reception, is really overwhelming. We appreciate everybody. I want to thank the Ikono local government chairman. From the first day I met him, I want to tell you, I don't look for him, he looks for me. So that tells you the love he has for his community. Mr. Chairman, thank you very much for your love, your support for the community.
On behalf of AKISAN USA Incorporated, the president, Lady Itauma, also used the moment to donate medical equipment worth in excess of 3 million naira to the Ikono General Hospital.
AKISAN has also donated supplies. Let me look at the supplies. We've donated supplies over 3 million naira to this facility. We want to especially thank Dr. S. Oinyam, the lead physician who collected this equipment and supplies that we've been able to donate to this facility. We also have, besides what you see here, we've also donated autoclave for the theater and other surgical equipment and supplies.
Perhaps the highest donation of items this year. Because of me.
The visibly excited and elated Ikono Council boss could not contain his joy as he thanked his benefactors for coming all the way from the United States to spend their hard-earned dollars and expertise to undertake 61 surgical operations as well as administer treatment to over 1,500 of his kid and key. He used the moment to solicit that the Ikono local government area the father included in the subsequent years of the medical outreach program.
Witness this epoch-making five-day medical outreach that was initiated by AKISAN, a private community in the U.S.
And I'd like to thank His Excellency the Governor, who has also assisted AKISAN in ensuring that we have this. And our mother, Her Excellency the wife of the Governor, who through her pet project, Ferep, has also assisted. But I'd like to also thank my sister. I got to know about the story, you know, the history behind the selection of Ikono as one of the benefiting, you know, locations. And I'd like to specially thank someone who took the bullet for Ikono people, even when we were not there. I learned she fought, you know, so hard to convince the entire council and the entire team to enlist Ikono as one of the beneficiaries. I'd like to thank Auntie Eneben. God bless you. Thank you. I'd like to congratulate all those who have benefited. 1,500 cases in 5 days. That's unprecedented. About 61 very successful surgeries. Some of them are very high level surgeries. You know, some techs, you know, the doctor was sharing with me that they had to spend 6 hours on one patient alone. And if we were to place a price on what has been done for the people of Ikono in 5 days, I doubt if, as local government chairman, even my allocation for 6 months wouldn't be able to foot the bill of what we're doing. My heart goes out to AKISAN. I want to thank them for what they're doing. Imagine them traveling long distance, you know, coming down here, spending their hard-earned money. They came here on holidays, but ever since they arrived here, someone like Dr. Otong, he has no sleep. You know, they have been battling from morning till night to ensure that our people are served. And when it came around, especially I was very happy we had a meeting on Sunday. And I got to know that a large chunk of those who are coming to Ikono are actually natives of Ikono.
Yes,
and I was very proud.
Yes,
you remember at the meeting on Sunday, I think I was the only chairman that was there. Yes. When I saw them, I said, wow, so we have so many Ikono people who are patriotic and committed in wanting to give back to society, traveling all the way from the United States to come render these services. Dr. Tong, I can't thank you enough. Dr. Kieran Ekpotu mentioned to me and said, there is something about the Ikono spirit. There's a driving force behind every Ikono man. The passion, you know, for the best for their people is unprecedented, and that's part of our USP. So I'd like to thank everybody who has contributed in making this a huge success. I look forward to having Ikono enlisted again next year. Madam President.
Thereafter, the lead surgeon in Ikono Medical Outreach, the staff of the University of Oyotishin Hospital, Dr. Otobong Asukwo, and other medical personnel heaped copious praise on the AKISAN team and the Ikono Council Box for partnering to ensure a smooth sale of the exercise.
What we came here to do is purely humanitarian. We came here to sacrifice for people. I want to say that if we were to pay, we've done a lot of surgeries, ranging from thyroidectomy, myomectomy, a lot of lumpectomy, a neuropathy. If we were to pay for it, imagine an uncomplicated neuropathy goes for about 150,000 naira in town. Then we did a lot of complicated ones, giant size. We had those ones that all the intestines were already in the anus. We removed a lot of them. Maybe that's why we had to do that number, because we would have done more than that. There were some surgeries like myomectomies, we had to spend close to 3-4 hours in one cases. We also recorded the baby. There's nothing as good as going for a mission and you have a baby in the mission.
Yeah.
Always focus on especially obstetricians like us. And we also registered no complication. You know, when you go for missions, you watch out for people watching out for. There were so complications. There were so dead. We did not record any death, and we did not record any complications. And we want to give glory to the Almighty God, because it's not by the skills, it's not by our zeal, it's not by our strength, but the Almighty that shows favor to whom He shows favor to. The eye section, I want to thank the chairman. The chairman, in short, when I gave him a call, he responded immediately. I was so surprised. What impressed us with Mrs. Tuma was when he came to the venue and she was not there, and I now had to apologize and tell him to come back. He still came back, had meetings with us, helped us in the various areas we asked him to. I want to use the opportunity to thank Dr. Emeka Zibasi for allowing us to come out and partake in this program. And I want to say that wherever he is, God should bless him. And for all the people that came from teaching hospital and other centers to partake, may God bless you and grant you joining mercies. President, you reach yes safely. Thank you very much.
And with all smiles recently, the cradle of the Nubian civilization, when AKISAN, USA Incorporated, a group group of Akwaibom indigents based in the United States of America visited home to organize a five-day medical surgery and outreach program for the natives of the area. The AKISAN team must be commended for going out of their way to organize a medical outreach. We saw over 1,500 cases attended to in Ikono General Hospital, with 61 of them being surgical operations. Special kudos also goes to the wife of the governor, Her Excellency Mrs. Martha Ujomi-Mano, for partnering the group through her pet project, Ferret, and the Ikono Council boss, Ms. Ithero Colomba, for buying and donating the over 500 eyeglasses that were distributed to the natives. Indeed, it is the dawn of a new era in Ikono, and we return all the glory to the Almighty.